So today's Tuesday, that means I'm working on my thesis today, and I'm going to do a video update about where I'm at with my thesis. So if you didn't see last Tuesday's video, I'm a master's student at NYU's Interactive Telecommunications program, and this is my last semester, and I have to do a thesis. And so check out the video for a little bit more background about where my head was last week and what I wanted to explore. I received so many great comments and so much great feedback about what I was exploring. And it's helped a lot. It definitely helped a lot. And so I'm glad to be doing another Thesis Tuesday video. Now, of course, it really ought to be Thesis Thursday, but the schedule just didn't work out for me to do it that way. So it's Thesis Tuesday. Sorry. So check out last week's video. I actually am wearing a different shirt than I was last time. I have a lot of the same shirts. Anyway, one of the comments I got on the video was from Maximax, and he said, "You should check out the library box. It's a forked pirate box, a hacked router which creates an open network for file sharing and chatting. The library box shares books or even a copy of Wikipedia's pages." So I went and checked that out, and this is a project by Jason Griffey. I presume that's how he says his name. And this is a lot of what I already want to do, actually, is a portable private digital distribution system that is a device that has information on it. It doesn't rely on the internet to go out and get information. And so I thought, well, there's the other whole part of my thesis that I was thinking about, which is about how we want to put on display the information that we have in the home. Just like the set of encyclopedias, the atlas, the globe that sits there, the telescope, which shows like, hey, we're interested in information and exploration. Let's have it out there. And this doesn't achieve that. So I thought, well, perhaps, the area of the thesis that I'll explore is how we show information and how we show that we have information. And that idea is still on the table, but it's not really the essence of what I'm interested in. It's not really like what I'm passionate about. So I'm still exploring the library box. It's an open source project. I can extend it a bit if I want. I can work off of it. I can see what it is. I'm also checking out the Pirate Box, which is by David Dartz, which is just a local intranet, a Wi-Fi intranet that sits in a little box and people can share files or communicate with each other. I like these ideas. I like these sort of appliances, these small network appliances that use the network. And it reminded me of the L Train Network. A project is just one of my favorite projects ever. A group of people, including a friend of mine, Sean, they made these local Wi-Fi intranets, and they brought them onto the L Train, the subway here in New York City, and served up content from local artists and let people chat with each other or do other interactive things on their phones if they logged into their Wi-Fi network on the L Train. And I've always loved that project, and I thought it was fantastic. So this is sort of the realm I want to work in. And there's still time to kind of change things up a little bit. I still have a few weeks, quite a few weeks before I need to present a thesis. And I met with my a thesis advisor, a faculty advisor yesterday, and I just had to kind of talk about where my brain is. And one of the things that I was thinking about is that, like, I think where my passion really is about creating something network attached, a device that attaches to the network, that's a part of the network, and does something that's unconventional with the network. Perhaps it's some kind of unconventional filter, perhaps it is some kind of cache, but it doesn't necessarily need to be a reference shelf. And I think a reference shelf, because because the library box already exists, I may even want to move away from that. And I was thinking about, well, we were brainstorming, and I was saying, well, what if, like, just like you have guitar pedals and they have their whatever effect on the audio going in and out, what if there was a bit of a guitar pedal for the internet and you could kind of like tweak and make your internet connection a little funky in different ways that you want? And so I was picturing maybe a box that had different switches that created different filters on the contents that came through the pipe. It's a weird idea. It's a little strange. It falls into the idea of kind of what theses are at ITP. So I'm exploring that, and I'm curious to know what you guys think of where I'm going and if you see anything out there. I want to thank everybody who commented, who sent me an email or tweet. I really appreciate it. It's been so helpful. I love hearing ideas, and I love communicating back and forth about the thesis. This has been great for me, and I hope it's actually interesting for you. So please send me an email or a tweet. My email address is matt@mattrichardson.com, or my Twitter is just mattrichardson. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you've seen anything out there that this reminds you of, or if possibly there's something that you could see an application of this for. Thank you also for watching the vlog. This is a big beta experiment and a beta test, and you guys are my beta viewers, and I appreciate that deeply. Let me know what you think of the video series. Tomorrow I'm back on my normal videos. It's just a Tuesday thing where I'll be talking about my thesis. Anyway, have a great day, and thanks for watching. Bye.